difficult place when it gets like this. Uh-huh. It's hard to raise a child when it gets like this. Uh-huh. Oh, giving this smile with my own day wish. Uh-huh. But it's hard to do you right when it gets like this. Uh-huh.
Hey guys, so today I am doing this look here. So I like to call this the snow globe effect. Contrast of light and dark. I actually did it more dramatic with the whole, what is this? The gunmetal and white eyeshadow. I made it more dramatic just so you guys could see the difference. You could definitely mix and match. You don't have to use this color scheme, but you do want to use a lighter and a little darker contrast. And I actually added a layering effect to the both the light and dark shades, just to create more depth where the my outer corners are, and especially even in my highlights. All right, so enough talking, let's get started. So I finished my base. I did my foundation, concealer, some contouring, my brows. Now I'm just gonna go off by my eyes, lips, and cheeks. I would say the easy stuff, but. Oh, shout out to my boyfriend. My camera lens broke. I don't wanna get into that, but. Yeah, so my boyfriend fixed it. He's amazing. He fixes everything. I don't know what I'd do without him. So yeah, let's get started, guys. I'm gonna go in with my Urban Decay palette in full spectrum. It's happening. Such a pretty palette. I haven't had a chance to play with it yet. Well, I have, obviously, but not for you guys on camera. So this is pretty exciting. I will be doing more bold looks for this palette, but right now I want to stick with the snow globe effect. Anastasia Beverly Hills contour palette. This is in light to medium, and I don't know why I keep these. I feel like if my palette breaks, this still won't do anything. I don't know why I keep these, so. Let's take the more warmer color right over here. I'm gonna use this actually as my transition color, so my crease color. Platonic. It's this, it's like a gunmetal. I'm gonna pull it up just a little bit if I'm doing like a cat eye. And just blend it towards the middle of my eye. So I'm just making my placement right now. So don't worry about blending it yet. And I'm gonna switch out this brush for a smaller brush because my eyelid is smaller and it closes up right here. So I'm gonna get a smaller brush for that. Yeah, I'm just gonna take any black eyeshadow I could find and dip that in, and I'm going to create more depth, make a slight V shape. I'm gonna take that crease shade again and just touch up. A longer, thinner brush, and this is not in white.
this one.
Evenly distribute it on my hands. Go straight down the middle of my eye. And how I figure out how far I want to take in this highlight, I keep it on, from the outer corner of my iris to the inner corner. So that's the perimeter I want to keep it in. Now I'm going to take Iced. It's a really, really pretty like silver. I'm going to blend it out a bit. What we're going to do right now is we are layering the highlight. So I'm taking that silver shade and now I'm taking a more snow pure white. And I'm going to be putting it right in the smack middle of this silver. I'm going to use Pretty Pearls. This is in my Wishes Come True palette. Blend all the way up. See the difference? I mean, it's really tedious, this whole layering thing, but it really makes a huge difference, especially on camera. So I'm just gonna blend that out a tad bit. So this layering is actually mimicking the way that light hits gunmetal, and I'm just gonna touch it up and bring it back in. My transition shade, I'll just be bringing down here. I'm not gonna be too shy. I'm gonna bring it down to my under eye area. I am going to actually highlight first with my concealer and the lightest shade that they have, which is this shade right here, I'm gonna use that. I'm going to just kind of the same thing with the concealer. I'm just aligning it just to create that layering effect again. This is my favorite part, the highlight. And this is in NYX in Away We Glow. And this is in Crystal Glare. So I'm gonna be putting it on my hand. I'm just gonna wipe it all on there. The camera was just being really crazy right now. So I'm gonna show you guys again. So I just wanna distribute it on my hand just to, for it to blend since I already have powder. It's not gonna blend as well. So I'm just gonna go here, 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 and here. And some there. And I just wanna make sure to blend that really, 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 really well. Now I'm gonna go into my Nars palette. And from this shade right here, whoops, see those little things? So I'm gonna go in with this shade, which is a highlighter shade, the fluffiest little eyeshadow brush that I have. And I'm just gonna dip it in there. And I'm going to do that whole layering. Thank you guys so much for watching my video. So this is your final look. I hope this was very informative and also just really fun. If you guys haven't subscribed to my channel yet, please subscribe. I will be posting videos weekly, hopefully, let's say most likely. Keep watching and I'll be seeing you guys next time. Bye. Or highlight really just really creates, what the fuck is that word? Really creates that effect. My light went out. Palette in full spectrum.